गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल. आई डॉक्टर प्रतिमा पवार, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जुओलॉजी, दादा पाटील महाविद्यालय, कर्जत. वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस सेशन फॉर एमएससी पार्ट सेकेंड. एंड द टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डील टुडे इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू इम्यूनोलॉजी. सो हियर let's discuss what is immunology. Immunology is a branch of biology that covers the study of immune system in all the organisms. Immunology charts and measures the physiological functioning of the immune system in states of both health and disease. The malfunctioning of the immune system in immunological disorders such as autoimmune diseases, hypersensitivities, immune deficiency, and transplant rejection. Whereas the physical, chemical, and physiological characteristics of the components of the immune system in vitro, in situ, and in vivo. Immunology has applications in numerous disciplines of medicine, particularly in the field of organ transplantation, oncology, rheumatology, virology, bacteriology, parasitology, and dermatology. So, we can state that immunology is the study of organs, cells, and molecules which are responsible for the consequences. They are either desirable or undesirable in the way in which they can be advantageous, increased, or reduced. In short, immunology is the study of the immune system and its responses to the invading pathogens. This physiological function of the immune system is to prevent infections and to eradicate established infections. This is the principal context in which immune responses are discussed. So here we can say that immunology is the study of the immune system, where the immune system tries to protect the body of the organism either from infections which are present in the body, or the pathogens which are present in the body, or the coming infections which have yet to be there. So what is immunity? So we have seen it's the study of immune system. So let's discuss about what is immunity. Yes, can we guess what is immunity? Immunity is defined as resistance to diseases, specifically infectious diseases. So immunity is concerned with those diseases, especially where there is infection, where this disease is caused by other microbes, viruses, bacteria, or other pathogens. The collection of cells, tissues, and molecules that mediate resistance to infection is called as the immune system. So it's a group of cells or molecules or tissues which in coordination works, where these cells or molecules give a response against the microbes, and this is called as the immune response. Immunity is concerned with the recognition and disposal, usually in the form of life-threatening infectious microorganisms. So here we can see that the immunity, it is more concerned with the recognition to identify and disposal, that is damaging the life-threatening infectious microorganism. The immune system. We recognize that the immune system is an integrated network of cells, molecules, and organs, and that each component relies on the rest to function properly. In the same way, we have seen that as in a family, each and every person is dependent upon the other person for working or functioning properly. In the same way, the immune system is an integrated network where each cell Each molecule and all the organs work together and function properly so as to develop the immune system. This presents a pedagogical challenge because to understand the whole, we must attain working knowledge of many related pieces of information, and these do not always build upon each other in simple linear fashion. So as we know that they have a sequence, they have a multidimensional work which is going on where the immune system is divided into many sub-fragments, and they, each one, depends upon the other for its proper functioning. Okay, now in acknowledgement of this challenge, we present the big picture. So as we are talking about the immune system, it's a very big, it's a large, collage picture. Okay, twice. First, as an introductory overview of immunity, we can just see the introduction to the immunity, and then we can go into the details. We'll just see the overview of the immune system. The immune system evolved to protect multicellular organisms from pathogens. The evolution itself of the immune system is for protection of the organisms from the pathogens. Now, all of you must be knowing what does pathogen means. Any foreign organism which causes harm to the host is called as a pathogen. Highly adaptable. Now, these are highly adaptable. It defends the body against invaders. The overview of immune system. The immune system evolved to protect multicellular organisms from pathogens. So, the immune system's development and evolution itself is for protecting the body from the pathogens. So, all of you must be knowing what are pathogens. Pathogens are those microorganisms which causes harm to their host. Highly adaptable. So the immune system is highly adaptable. It defends the body against the invaders. Okay, who are the invaders? Who are not the part of the body. As diverse as the tiny, similar to 30 nm intracellular virus that causes polio, that is the polio virus, which is one of the smallest virus, and as large as the giant parasitic kidney worm. So here we can see it can be as small as the polio virus or as large as the parasitic kidney worm, which can grow to over 100 cm in length and 10 mm in width. So we can see it doesn't has a barrier of size. It can have molecules or organisms which are very small in their size, whereas it may need to fight with a giant parasitic kidney worm which is 100 cm in length. Okay, now the diversity of potential pathogens requires a range of recognition and destruction mechanism to match the multitude of invaders. Like, the body has different functions and it has different organs for carrying out this function. In the same way, as there are different types of pathogens, the body's immune system has a mechanism, has a wide range of recognition and destruction mechanism which can match this multitude of the invaders. So as there is a demand of different type of as there is infection I'm As there is infection of different types of organism, there is a defense mechanism which can tackle each type of this pathogen. To accomplish this feat, vertebrates have evolved as complicated and dynamic network of cells, molecules, and pathways. Although elements of these network can be found throughout the plant and animal kingdom, the focus will be on highly evolved mammalian immune system. So here we are going to study the mammalian system in more detail. Okay, so before studying the mammalian system, just have an overlook on the organs of the immune system. The important lymphoid organs of the immune system are the thymus, the bone marrow, the chief lymphatic tissues such as the spleen, tonsils, lymph vessels, lymph nodes, adenoids, and liver. When healthy conditions worsen to emergency situations. Okay, this status of emergence, the portions of immune system organs, including the thymus, the spleen, the bone marrow, lymph nodes, and other lymphatic tissues, can be surgically excised for examination when the patient are still alive. So we can see that even if they are the important organs of the immune system, the patient can survive even in their absence, even if they are surgically removed. Many components of the immune system are typically cellular in nature and not associated with any specific organ. So here we can see that there are different components of the immune system, but they are cellular in nature, hence they are not associated with any specific organ. So they are distributed throughout the body, but they are rather embedded or circulating in various tissues located throughout the body. Here we can see the thymus, the lymph nodes near the neck or the cervical region. The diaphragm which divides the ribs and the stomach, okay, which is a portion which allows a partition between the respiratory system and the digestive system. The armpit, that is the axillary lymph nodes, liver, spleen, the cells of the immune system, lymphocytes, okay. The T cells, the B cells, and the NK cells, that is the natural killer cells, the neutrophils, the monocytes, macrophages. These are all the types. These all types are of the white blood cells. We know that the white blood cells are commonly called as the soldiers of our body, and they form the key components of the immune system of the body. Here we can see there are different barriers to naturally avoid the infection. We can see the physical barrier like the mucous membrane and the skin of the human body, chemical barriers like high pH in the stomach, the bile juice, the different secretions of the intestine, barriers like the lacrimal gland, which are found in the eyes, tears as one of the barriers for stopping the infection in the eyes. Immunology, as we know, okay, has to tackle different invaders like pathogens, viruses, bacteria, fungus, carcinogenic substances, germs, and toxins. The process of immunity can be divided into three lines. The first line of defense is called as the to block the entry of the invaders, pathogens, germs. Okay, this can be done by the primary line of action, for example, the skin. Okay, the second line of defense to fight local infection. This can be seen that whenever there is a wound, the skin itself has or forms a its line of action and stop this. And the third line of action or defense is to combat major infections in the body. When there is a large damage due to a pathogen, the third line of defense works over it. The process of immunity. How does the body follows this function of the immune system? The first is recognition, the highly specific and distinguishes one foreign pathogen from the other. So the body is so well versed in this identification of the pathogens that it can distinguish between specific germs and pathogens from the others. Furthermore, it discriminates among the single molecule and the body's own molecules. So they can discriminate between the pathogenic molecules, external molecules, that is any particle of other thing which comes into the contact of the body. Okay. Responses. However, if of two types, effector response and the receptor response. The foreign pathogen is recognized. The immune system of the body recruits a variety of cells and molecules to neutralize and eliminate the invaders. We can see whenever there is external forces acting against the body's own defense mechanism recognizes these forces and they build their own army against it to neutralize and eliminate the invaders. Etymology. How this word immune system or immunology came into force? The term was coined by a Russian biologist Ilik Makhnov, whose advanced studies on the immunology etymology. This is the study of the words. Okay, the term immunology was coined by Russian biologist Ilya Makhnikov, who advanced studies on the immunology and received the Nobel Prize for his work in 1908. He pinned small thorns into the starfish larvae and noticed unusual cells surrounding the thorns. So what he did, he took a larvae of a starfish and then he noticed that if thorns are pinned inside this larvae, after some days the thorns are surrounded by cells. This was the active response of the body trying to maintain its integrity. So now this is what immunity is about. The body tried to save itself from the thorns by aggregating some cells around the thorn. It was Makhnikov who first observed the phenomena of phagocytosis. So he for the first time observed phagocytosis, in which the body defends itself against a foreign body. Prior to the designation of immunity, from the etymological root immunis, which is Latin from exempt, earlier physicians characterized organs that later be proven as essential components of the immune system. So it was seen that the term immunology came from the word immunis. The pioneers in the immunology are Edward Jenner, 1749 to 1823. He discovered that cowpox induces protection against smallpox. So one disease, that is the cowpox, could induce protection against the other disease, that is the smallpox. Whereas Louis Pasteur, 1822 to 1895, he confirmed from his experiments that the germ theory of diseases also created the first vaccine for rabies. And we can see that there are 13 Nobel laureates in the field of immunology. So 13 scientists have been given Nobel prizes for their eminent and helpful work in the field of immunology. Let's see the historical perspective. The discipline of immunology grew out of the observation that individuals who recovered from the certain infectious diseases were there after protected from the disease. So it was seen that once a person gets a disease and if he recovers from that disease, he has some type of immunity against the disease. So even now we know that this is a proven fact that once a person's body is exposed to some type of disease and germs, the second attack by the same germ forms antibodies. The Latin term immunis, meaning exempt, is a source of the English word immunity, a state of protection from infectious diseases. Perhaps the earliest written references to the phenomena of immunity can be traced back to Thucydides. In describing a plague in Athens, he wrote in 1430 BC that only those who have recovered from the plague could nurse the sick because they would not contract the disease a second time. So in 430 BC only, 430 BC, he understood that once a person suffers from the disease, the second time he forms the immunity against the disease. Although early societies recognized the phenomena of immunity almost 2000 years passed before the concept was successfully converted into medically effective practice. So it took 2000 years for making it practical. The fully functional immune system evolves so many organs, molecules, cells, and pathways in such an interconnected and sometimes circular process that it is often difficult to know where it starts. So we cannot tell actually how the process happens, but it's in a circular process. So we can see that the cycle keeps on going. Hence, it is very difficult to state where it has started. Recent advances in cell imaging, genetics, bioinformatics, as well as cell and molecular biology have helped us to understand many of the individual players in the great molecular deal. So, due to advances in the technology nowadays, we can understand who actually and which molecule helps in the different pathways whereas infections. However, a focus on the details, and there are many, can make taking a step back to see the bigger picture changing. And it is often the bigger picture that motivates us to study immunology. So it is often said that a big picture is always necessary to get the insight. In the same way, the study of immunology on a broader scale is necessary for motivating us to study immunology. Indeed, the field of immunology can be credited with the vaccines that eradicated